Hi, I'm Heather at the Kraaft Shaak, where we believe all were created by the Creator to be creative. Join me now for another art adventure. Thank you so much for joining me today. I have something a little special, a little unique. We are working with a subscription box that I recently received for the first time, and I am very excited about this. And today we are working on an ATC, which is a part of their, it's like a monthly contest that they do, and they provide the ATC card and encourage you to play along and post, and then you have an opportunity to win a subscription box in the future. So it's really kind of a cool thing. So before I get into the subscription box and everything, I want to kind of catch you up with what I'm doing here. They give you this ATC. It's pre-cut. And I think this one was watercolor paper. I'm not positive. It doesn't really say, but it doesn't really matter either because it kind of reacted very, very well with those Inktense blocks. And then I am using some light and fluffy. This is really amazing modeling paste. It is super light and super fluffy, and it's something I've never used before. It's by, I forgot the name already. How could I do that? It is by the Crafters Workshop Light and Fluffy Modeling Paste, and they give you a whole 8-ounce bottle in this subscription box. And if you're interested in learning more about this, subscription box I'm talking about, I do detail it in a blog post that is over on the website. So I encourage you to go check that out and learn more about it. I do kind of describe the prices and how it works and everything there. So I'm not going to really go into that much in this video. I just wanted you to see the process of making this ATC using these cool products that I got in this box. So one of the items that came in the box was a mixed media pad in a very different size of 3 inches by 9 inches pad of paper. I was really surprised by that because it's kind of cool. It makes really neat bookmarks, and that's sort of a foreshadowing of something I'll show you later on in the episode. But we also got these 4 Inktense blocks, and if you've never played with Inktense before, then you are missing out on a really unique item. It has the properties of watercolors without with the properties of permanent acrylics. So let me explain that again. It's similar to a watercolor in the sense that it goes on dry, like you saw me draw with it there, and then I can activate it with just a wet paintbrush. But as you watch me paint this flower in, you'll notice that it will stop moving. The color will stop moving at some point. And that's as it dries, it becomes permanent. So this is a unique property because when you're doing mixed media, you almost never know exactly what you're going to do next. You may plan and you may have ideas and you may set yourself up properly and everything, but you may end up going, oh, I know what I want to add to this. And inevitably, it is something that goes down wet. Well, if you have watercolors or watercolor-based crayons like Caran d'Ache or any of those kind of things, then once you add more water or more liquid to your image, it may distort it or run it or ruin it altogether. So with Inktense, you have this really cool property where you can get it wet, move it around, and you see me doing the inside section here of this flower, and that allows those petals to kind of dry. And I'll start moving around a little bit, dragging that color out, creating some details with it, but as we go, you'll notice that it's not going to move as much, and that's because it has dried some. See, we're already starting to see limits of the movement. Can't activate that very much. And that's because it has been activated by water and then dried. And once it's dry, see it? Doesn't move very much, if at all. So with that, we know that we could go in with, say, matte medium or some other kind of liquid medium that we could go over the top of this and it won't smear it, which is a really cool property when you're doing mixed media because, as I said, you never really know exactly what you're going to do next. So with that in mind, those properties in mind, I'm just trying to always using just water on the brush. That's all you see me using at this point. I'm not putting it into any kind of pigment or anything. I'm just activating that color and moving it around to color in my shapes. Now, I will admit to you that when I started this project, my only inspiration was the devotional that came with this box. And I was so excited to see they give a full color, 8.5 by 11 page, two-sided devotional that gives you a great opportunity to get into the Word of God and to just be inspired by that. And to be amazed was basically the title of this. And so while I was making these objects, I was thinking about that devotional and I was thinking about being amazed by what I see around me, amazed by nature, really. It always amazes me how under adverse, I live in Arizona right now and the desert is just adversity in a nutshell. And when you see the adversity all around you and yet life still abounds, it is amazing. So I did take that Inktense block in the yellow color and added it to the center, and you can see how opaque it is. Now, I'm not going to activate that with a wet brush. I'm leaving that solid so that it remains opaque over the top of that center, and I just thought that was a great addition and a different way to use those Inktense blocks. Now, like I started to say, I really had no direction about where I was going with this. I just knew that I wanted to do something in the form of nature. And, of course, I always go to flowers. Well, and flowers don't really exist without leaves, so I had to do some kind of leaves. And I thought, this will be fun. I'll just do some wonky leaf shapes. And I really kind of like how organic it was. It was just draw them out and, you know, let them be what they are. And I'm just using that wet brush to activate the green. And I'll get you the list of those actual colors. The Shiraz is kind of a pinkish or maroonish color. Mustard is that yellow that I used in the centers. Leaf green, that's what we're using now. And then mauve. Oh, I apologize. Shiraz was the purple that I used for the flower. And mauve is that burgundy color there on the other flower. All right, so I'm using the water on the brush to activate the drawing, basically, and make sure that there isn't any unactivated Inktense. Because when I go to glue this on, I wasn't exactly sure what I was going to do. Would I need to glue it on with matte medium? And if so, then when I go to brush over the top of the leaves, it's going to smear. So I do a little trick here because I know I'm going to be cutting these out. So I take my wet brush, and we'll do that here in a second. Here we go. And I just swipe over the entire thing. I did kind of let it dry just a second or two. And now I'm activating every aspect of the leaves. And the reason why I did this is so when I cut it out, there wouldn't be any, I don't have to be perfect about cutting it for one thing, but two, there wouldn't be any non-colored areas because it is so, so specific. The cutting out is going to be just real, real fidgety. And so I didn't want there to be any part of it to be white and obvious that I didn't cut it out. So that was how I simplified it for myself. And plus it made it so that if I do go over it with like matte medium or anything like that, it wasn't going to smear and get all over the rest of the ATC. So now I'm going to give you a couple of tips if you've never done fussy cutting. That's what we call it when we cut out the edges around objects like these flowers and these leaves. I'm going to give you a couple of tips. I always start by cutting out broadly around the object. Then, because I'm right-handed, I hold the scissors in my right hand, and they're pretty much still. And then I move the object around and not the scissors. So you see me doing that here nice and slow, and this is all in real time. And cut away what I don't want on my piece. Now, if you've never done fussy cutting before, or fussy cutting frustrates you, or maybe you just don't have success for it, try using these tips. First, cut it kind of in a broad way with a large outline around it. Then, with your non-dominant hand, hold the object and move the object, not the scissors. I find this very therapeutic and would do this in front of like the television watching one of Mr. Crafter's TV shows. I like to just sit there and do stuff like this because then I'm spending time with him, but I don't have to actually watch the TV show he likes to watch. Now, I'm not going to make you sit through every one of these as I cut them all out, I promise. I just wanted you to see how easy it is to do fussy cutting, and everything is trimmed out. That wasn't too bad. About a minute, if that long. All right, so here we go. Now, this was sort of an afterthought. I'm like, okay, they look cool-ish, but they need more detail. So how am I going to do this? So I basically made myself a little palette of the ink tents, add a little bit of water to make a really deep looking palette of water of color, and then just sort of ran the brush around the edges. And I really liked how it puddled and made those darker blobs like that. So I did this all the way around, some areas really leaving it blobby. That's a technical term, by the way. And in some areas, not doing it at all. And then I decided to make a little bit more. So draw on some more color and add some more water. And now flick on, yeah, pick up the color and then flick on little specks. And that was perfect. Now, I like to make my flecks or splatters by knocking the paintbrush against something, like in this case it's the scissors, but then they flick just fine. That's the best way I've found to do splatters. And once it's dry, it's permanent and it's gonna be great, so it won't affect our end piece at all. So of course I had to add the same effect to the other flowers, and I used the mauve here, and I was thinking when I did the mauve that actually I think I accidentally did the mauve. I was going to use the purple or the Shiraz, and then I was going to do that little flower, and I realized I really liked how that little flower looked really delicate, and I didn't want to add these big heavy blobs to the end of the delicate petals, so I just added it to this flower, and the effect, in my opinion, is wonderful. And then adding a few details with it as well pushes some of those petals back and makes it just have that much more dimension. And as it dries, it's really cool. One of the things about Inktense blocks is that when they dry, they kind of have this matte finish to them. They're not glossy at all, and they just give a real neat watercolor look that is permanent. So now here we have all of our components, and I'm bringing out the devotional card to tell you, to be amazed was the theme, and I really wanted to remember that. And the best part about the devotional for me was bringing up the Sermon on the Mount. And I thought, as I looked at this, I wanted to make sure that I remembered that, so I'm writing in the verse reference, which is Matthew chapters 5 through 7. And as I'm doing this portion right here, just writing it in, I'm thinking to myself, now, I got from the devotional to be amazed, and nature really inspired what I did with those images, but now how do I put it all together? How do I remember when I look at this ATC that to be amazed and the Sermon on the Mount, that those two things were the keys that I brought from this devotional? And so I'm looking at the front of the card and where I had put that modeling paste over the top of the yellow. And I'm gonna just sort of lay things over, and I'm like, you know what? We need to do something with that modeling paste, and we're gonna stop right here because I wish I would not have done this part. I really wish I would not have done this part because at this stage of the game, everything pops right off of that yellow. But I really wanted you to see that you can actually color this modeling paste with these inktense blocks. You can do it with acrylic paints. You can do it with anything. You can even do it before you spread it. You can actually color the paste and create a colored paste that you put through the stencil as well. But I wanted you to see that on video, and so I did this. And now I'm really doubting that decision because although it's a cool concept, and it's definitely a unique property and one that you should know about if you're going to use these products, I don't think it fit the best for this ATC card. And as I was painting the raised areas, the dimensional part, I was thinking, I may have made a mistake. Now, I don't know about you. I don't know how this works when you're doing your art. But every once in a while, I think to myself, I may have made a mistake. Now, I don't put the paintbrush down and throw fit, and I don't put this item in the trash either. I keep going because at some point, there's something around the corner somewhere that's going to make a difference. And so I think we'll get to that point. But, you know, another option, whenever you're having difficulties or maybe you feel like you may have made a mistake, just put it down. So let's take a little commercial break and talk about this subscription box. As I said, I wrote a blog post about it. This is an image of what was in our very first premium subscription box. And I did an unboxing, if you will, and an exploration of this box where we created this bookmark as well as another little tag that had all the elements on it, and it was so much fun. We had a great time. Please visit craftshack.com blog post to see more about that and to even view the opening. I have it linked there. So as I got to this stage of the game, I realized, you know, it does kind of look like a grassy hill, doesn't it? And I'm really thinking Sermon on the Mount when I see that grassy hill. So I guess it's not all too bad, but going back to where I said I wish I would have stopped, see how the green just blends right into that grassy hill? That bums me out. But it's all right, because it's still going to look great in the end. I would have liked it to have popped off that yellow lip a little bit more, and to have that white peeking through would have been kind of a nice thing as well. But because it's permanent, we can't remove it. So there's nothing to do but make what has happened work. So I am auditioning, as they say, where each piece should go and feeling like, okay, maybe that's it. So I stated before that I wasn't totally sure how I was going to glue these pieces on, but I decided on just some art glitter glue. It's a great, great glue that holds just about everything. I've even glued seashells to canvas and fishing nets, so it must work great. So just put that on the back, hold it for a minute or two, and then we'll just keep going as we put on the rest of these pieces. Now, one of the things that we've been doing at the Craft Shack is we live stream on Tuesdays and Thursdays every week, and we've been doing it on both Twitch and YouTube. So if you're not a fan of Twitch, we have an option for you. You can actually watch on YouTube now, which is kind of cool. We also do some other fun things in our membership area, which are closed and private to those who have joined our membership over on the website. And one of my favorite things that we do is the Kraaft It Together. And we do that on the 15th of every month in a Zoom hangout together. And we just create, chat, hang out. It's lots of fun. There are other perks that you get for being a member as well, but we won't go into those today. You can check it all out on the website. Now, I trimmed off that little piece of the leaf, and I thought about trimming that flower But I talked myself out of it. I did decide to put down a black edge so that that way it sort of framed it and finished it, which I think was a great choice. Just using a Tombow, it's a Memento, not a Tombow, it's a Memento marker. Just basically water-based marker, it's not a big deal. And then I decided it needed a little pizzazz, and if you've been around here at the Kraaft Shaak a little while, then you know that I love gold. And so to break that mold just a little bit, I grabbed copper. And with the copper Liquitex ink, the only thing I grabbed from my stash to use that wasn't in the subscription box, and we're just going to put a few splatters on, and that just added to the whole thing. I hope you've enjoyed this ATC and that you will consider subscribing and following us along on Instagram, where we show behind the scenes and everything else. It's where we posted this. So check out the IlluminART Art Box and everything else that goes along with it. I appreciate you being here today. Have yourself a crafty day.